Acho, is Dak Prescott ranked too high in the quarterback rankings?
Duh.
Oh, you doing that? You doing that?
Yes, and I'm going to play a game with you shortly, but let me contextualize this for you all. Must I remind y'all that since 2018, Mitch Trubisky has been statistically a better quarterback than Dak Prescott. Now, you could just think I'm
He's
an
not on the line
player for making a statement, but no, I'm just going to contextualize something for y'all.
He's not on the list.
Mitch has a better winning percentage, and we have the full screen to throw up with y'all. Same number of Pro Bowl appearances and more playoff appearances. Now, digest it. Get rid of the full screen. I don't want it anymore.
You better get rid of that. I'm going to beat it
Why
up.
Why do I bring that up?
Let me see.
Because Mitch Trubisky is currently a backup quarterback to the fifth player on this list.
He's a Dak-up.
Exactly. And Dak is just two spots behind. Dak should be somewhere about 10 or 9 if you want to rank about what he's done or rank based upon projections.
What?
Now, here is a game that y'all can play too, because I don't just want to exclude y'all and play with Marcellus. At number 8 is Lamar Jackson. If Dak and Lamar were on the same team, who would start? Lamar Jackson. At number 10, I believe, is Kyler Murray. If Dak and Kyler were on the same team, who would start? Kyler Murray.
Kyler Murray, yeah, over who?
What you mean over who? You ain't seen Kyler Murray run?
Over who?
You ain't seen Kyler Murray run and not get hurt?
Over who?
If Dak Prescott
and not get hurt
if Dak
time,
Prescott and Justin Herbert were on the same team.
Oh, don't
team,
you do that.
Who would start?
The Chargers.
Exactly,
yes.
Justin Herbert.
Yes,
so even if you just want to play the game and put Dak Prescott on a roster with Mahomes, Mahomes starts. With Rodgers, Rodgers starts. Brady starts. Allen starts. Justin Herbert, Herbert starts. Put them on a roster with anybody in the top 10, and they will all start over Dak Prescott. He is far too high. He's the 10th best quarterback in my best estimation and summation. 10 is still great. Let's not sleep on top 10. But 7's just too high, big dog.
7's too high?
Yes, sir.
First, let's just get that conversation out the way. So if you were 6, are you lower or higher?
Too high? I could mess with you right now because 6 is a lower number than high. You're talking about he's higher. I don't know what you're saying, Acho, because I don't think you know what you're saying, Acho. Oh, my God.
I think he's ranked properly. If that's a thing in sports media today, to actually say something that is just full of common sense. Like, a guy who didn't play last year, who's still top 10 and is number 7 and is in a comfortable position. Now, look, you know I love me some Lamar Jackson. You know I love me some Justin Herbert. You know I love me some Kyler Murray. But at the same time, you got to respect equity. You got to respect a deeper resume than those guys. Now, Lamar Jackson is a different conversation. We'll have that conversation later in the show. But if you look at this ranking, I'm not going to be the one that argues against you because you want to slide him down. I thought you were going
to
go Ryan Tannehill. That's your guy. You try to slide him. You try to go joke.
I didn't even have to.
You should have because he had a better, deeper resume than Mitch Trubisky. Mitch Trubisky, oh, my God.
I was giving you context.
That wasn't
Mitch
context.
Mitch is better than Dak.
That was
I'm
extreme.
Letting you. Okay, extreme truth.
Okay, here's the greatest case for why Dak Prescott should be where he is, number 7. Because I see who's number 3, Tom Brady. And, God, he got 7 rings. That's amazing. But if you look at their passer ratings, which is accumulation of all of the statistics that we sit here with all these papers and notes trying to digest, you just want to sum it all up, kind of go to passer rating. It helps a lot. It's one of the better ones. Who has the same passer rating as Tom the Terrific, Tom Brady at number 3? Dak Prescott. Does Mr. Trubisky have that? No, he does not. So let's just get Mr. Trubisky out of here. And Mr. Trubisky got himself out of there, so we don't even got to go there. Let's talk about Dak Prescott, who's never had a losing record when healthy as the Cowboys starter. Let's talk about Dak Prescott in games where last year, if he would have been able to finish, he would have been number 1 in scoring. But he wasn't. But he still was number 1 in scoring, even in the 4-plus games that he was able to start. I am not going to go here and then all of a sudden try to slight Dak Prescott, who has a deeper resume than most of the guys that you're trying to now ascend above him. So I'm going to let somebody else do that. Got to bring in Fox NFL analyst Bucky Brooks, who I know is full of that ammo. So, Bucky, is Dak Prescott ranked too high in the quarterback rankings? Get Acho.
Absolutely not. In fact, he should be a top 5 player if you look at this objectively. I don't know what Dak Prescott did to Acho. Maybe Acho was in the mall and wanted an autograph and he bypassed him in Dallas. I don't know. But I don't know why all this slander is going towards Dak Prescott.
Yes, yes.
But when I look at it, and the fact that you even brought up Mitchell Trubisky, who is a beloved Tar Heel, But come on, Acho, what are we talking about? You're trying to say that Mitch Trubisky and Dak Prescott in the same conversation, but I guess what you're doing is you're using team stats. So when I look at that, all of those are team stats. Mm. But when I look at the individual stats, here's what I found on Mitch Trubisky. He barely averages over 200 passing yards per game.
Ooh.
Passer rating, 87.2. Mm. They're winning in spite of Mitch Trubisky, not because of Mitch Trubisky. Mm. And since you said he's a backup, let's talk about the guy that he's backing up in Buffalo, Josh Allen, since you have a love affair with Josh Allen. Josh Allen had a great year last year, MVP caliber year. But when I dig deeper in the numbers, I just discovered that Josh Allen only passed for over 200 plus yards per game last year. Prior to that, he was sub 200. Mm. I look at his passer rating, 90.4. That's well below Dak Prescott's 97.3, which ties in with Tom Brady. So by any measure, by any metric, Dak Prescott is a much better player. We look at these numbers that he's accumulated individually and as a team. He has been an outstanding quarterback who deserves his just due. He's a top five player. You need to treat him as such. Talk about him as you talk about one of the elite, because the other stuff that you're talking about doesn't make sense. He's an elite quarterback.
Somebody bring up the list, please.
You don't know.
Can I see the list?
It's right here.
Please.
You need that, need that in your life?
Bucky
yes.
Brooks. You said he's a top five.
Bring it up.
No, no, I don't want to see that list. I don't care about Mitch no more. I don't want to see Mitch no more. Let me see this list, please.
Salute.
Bucky Brooks, is Dak Prescott better than Patrick Mahomes? Huh? You lost your mic now?
Oh, yeah,
now
no.
You can't speak?
No.
Wi-Fi on that.
No.
No, thank you. Bucky Brooks, if Dak Prescott and Aaron Rodgers were on a team, who would start?
Aaron Rodgers.
Bucky Brooks, if Dak Prescott and Tom Brady were on a team, who would start, sir?
Tom Brady.
Bucky Brooks, if Dak Prescott and Russell Wilson were on a team, who would start, sir?
Oh, don't do this.
I don't know.
Now you don't
because
know.
Because I don't know if Russell Wilson can cook based on what I saw in the second half of the season when teams played So I don't know if Russell Wilson. You know. I don't know. We have to take that all the way through training camp.
We got
it. And if you're going to ask
compete.
Me about number five.
Sierra, man. Sierra,
Bucky. Okay, if you don't know, let me tell you, Bucky Brooks. Russell Wilson has missed the playoffs one time in 10 years because we came into the league together. Dak Prescott has made the playoffs two times in 5 years. So if you don't know, now you know, okay?
Because of Russell, or in spite of?
Both. Because let's not act like Russell Wilson has had phenomenal defenses.
Mr. No MVP vote, having but Dak got one before?
Ooh. A vote.
I don't give a darn what you say.
He hasn't been to a championship game since the Legion of Boom fell apart.
Ooh. Okay,
he hasn't
last time Dak went
3-6 in his last nine playoff games?
Here's the thing. If you all genuinely think that Dak Prescott is a better quarterback than Russell Wilson, we can't even keep having this. We're speaking different languages. We're speaking different. I'm not going to speak my native tongue.
I'm saying they're in the same conversation, Acho. They're in the same conversation. If we swap teams, if we swap the players on different teams,
I'm not saying that
Russell Wilson is going to be significantly more impactful in Dallas.
I'm glad he went there.
Dak Prescott in Seattle.
Bucky, I'm so glad you went there. We don't have to swap teams, Bucky, because we saw the two teams play this past year, and it was week 3 that we saw both of these teams play. And the Seahawks won by a touchdown.
Barely.
Exactly. But 25% of games are decided by how much? 4 points or less. 51% of games decided by 7 points or less. It was a 7-point game. So, yes, it was barely, but the whole league is decided by barely.
Barely.
Now,
7%.
With that being said, Bucky, we saw both quarterbacks on the field. We saw one quarterback with 4 minutes left drive down the field and only get a field goal. Another quarterback, Russell Wilson, drive down the field and get a touchdown. We saw one quarterback have a pivotal turnover early in the game, Dak Prescott. We saw another quarterback find a way to win. We don't have to parse this out and really try to figure out what would happen. No. We saw it, Bucky. And Russell Wilson is better than Dak.
Russell Wilson got to go against the Dallas defense.
You wish. The Seahawks defense was worse than the Cowboys defense in the first two games.
What?
You better look that up.
They were historically bad.
The Seahawks defense was worse than the Cowboys defense the first two games.
I don't know about worse. They were
probably as bad.
With all that being said, what?
We can NFL analyze if y'all want. We can opine if y'all want. But either way, we will result in Russell being better than Dak. Josh Allen, we know. is better than we know, Bucky.
No, we don't. We don't know that. We don't know that. We know he had a better year. We don't know he's a better player. Absolutely not. I just sat here and read the stats. Prior to last year, Josh Allen had never averaged more than 200 passing yards per game. I know you like individual stats, so let's talk about that. He hadn't averaged more than 200 passing yards as a quarterback. You sit here and beat up Cam Newton for not being able to pass the ball. Josh Allen was basically a different version, a lighter complexed version of Cam Newton. So if you don't like Cam, how can you like Josh? It's the same conversation that we're having. So what are we doing?
Bucky.
What are we talking
Bucky, yes. Cam Newton, Josh Allen had 4,900 total yards last year. Even in Cam Newton's MVP season, he ain't see those numbers. Bucky Brooks, don't do this.
Year before. It's a complete body of work. If we're talking about the top five quarterbacks of 2020, we're talking about now. The entire career has to be factored in.
The point, I understand what we're doing. Acho's trying to negate your point of he's top five. However, by trying to negate that point, you may be taking some other guys out of the top five and may have to insert Dak Prescott. You saying Josh Allen had 4,900 yards last year. Dak was on pace to having 5,900. Now, it's just the pace.
I don't want to hear about pace, Sal.
So if we're not going to hear about pace, we don't want to necessarily hear about just one year. We want to hear about total body of work. Because if we're just going to go just one year, then it's going to be a different conversation in terms of the greats. Here's my only point. Because Dak was on pace to doing some crazy stuff. And even before that, he had 4,900 yards in the year before injury. So don't act like Dak can't do it. So let's stop there. Here's the thing. Only thing I noticed on this list, not trying to move Dak out of it, move Dak up and down, that damn it's a gap between number one, two, and three, and then number four, number five, number six. It gets weird. Number one has been in three straight AFC championship games. Patrick Mahomes, number two, just won an MVP, and Aaron Rodgers, number three, got seven damn rings. And then you start skipping, and you blink, and now we're having conversations about Russell Wilson, who is 3-6 in his last nine playoff games, who can't win without the Legion of Boom, who can't cook. Then we start talking about guys who just had one great year.
Then we start talking about guys
who have never won a playoff game. Matthew Stafford, never won a playoff game, and literally is in this conversation. Dak Prescott has 10 more wins than Matthew Stafford, including last season, and Dak missed 11 games. Boy, this list is weird. And y'all crazy for trying to follow this list. But go ahead, Doc. You got something to say, Otto?
Yes, I do.
Go ahead and try to make some sense out of that.
If you want to look at body of work, Bucky, and if you want to ignore the recent, then Ben Roethlisberger needs to be a top five quarterback as well.
Then we ain't
if you want to sit
body.
Here, Bucky, and look at body of work.
You want to see a dead body?
We have to look at what is going on right here, right now. Present day. I'll give y'all the last 12 months. I'll give y'all the last 24 months. But, Bucky, I don't want to hear about what Dak did back in 2016 when Dez Bryant and Cole Beasley and Jason Witten was on the team before Jason went to the booth, came back out of the booth, and now played for the Raiders. I don't want to hear
about Josh Allen wouldn't be on the list if you're giving us 24 months. You know that, right?
Then let's look.
So, then Bucky's right.
Talk these 12. Can we talk 12?
You said 24. Why we got to talk 12? You just said
24. Even if you look at 24, Josh Allen is still as good as Dak. If not better.
Oh, no.
Oh, give me our camera. YouTube, frame that.
Bucky.
Don't put me in that.
Josh, look.
I cover my mouth.
Bucky.
I'm trying not to swear.
Bucky. Acho be fighting.
Josh Allen's last year, can we agree, was better than Dak Prescott's 2019?
Yeah.
Fair?
Yes.
It was a nice year.
Allen's last year was better than Bucky's than Dak's 2019.
Even though the Cowboys had the number one total offense.
But Josh Allen was a MVP runner-up last year.
No, Dak I'll give you that. I say yes.
Fair. We agree on that.
Dak some flowers. Too.
Dak Prescott's 2020 season ended after four games. Therefore, Josh Allen's 2019 season would trump Dak Prescott's 2020 season. So it sounds asinine when y'all are like, hell, y'all don't do all that.
Wait a minute.
The last 24 months, Josh Allen is still better than Dak. He beat him in both years. His 2020 is better than Dak's 2019, and Dak in 2020 got hurt.
So I'm supposed to believe that in a 2019 where Josh Allen was only averaging 193 passing yards per game with a passer rating of 85.3, which was up from that 67.9 that he had as a rookie. That's a better year than what Dak Prescott put up. That's what I'm supposed to believe.
That is
when
I love you too much.
All of the fire that you've given Cam Newton, and we're talking about that season being better than what Dak Prescott put up.
Wait,
what
then, what wait, wait. Then Dak,
Bucky, then Dak Prescott put up what year? In 2020, Dak Prescott played 4 games. Afterwards, he was hurt. He could no longer play. As a result, his team went 6-10 and missed the playoffs. Even in the midst of Josh Allen's 2019, where he put up atrocious numbers compared to his 2020, he was still present and his team made the playoffs. Yes, Josh Allen's 2019 is greater than a 4-game sample size of Dak Prescott's 2020.
Hey, Bucky, don't let him calendar shift like that, because that's what he's doing. He's calendar shift. Because in 2019, when Dak was putting up 4,900 yards and we didn't see the average of 200 yards per game, but Josh Allen, he wouldn't even been top 30. He would have been lower than 30. Been like, oh, you know how they always put of qualified passers because they'd be trying to put other dudes in there who don't really qualify? Yeah, he would have been so low. And then, so Dak is way up here. And then you have an MVP caliber season, you will go here. And Dak, because of injury, but on pace, 371 passing yards per game, 5,900 passing yards per game, but injury drops you to here. But no way would you
injuries
drop
count.
Under him.
How would you drop under him?
This isn't even a – this literally is no debate. This is not –
I know,
this is
so
not subjective.
You lost.
This is objective. The last 2 years – Dak Prescott has passed for 6,700 yards. Josh Allen has passed for 7,700. The last 2 years, Dak Prescott has 39 passing touchdowns. Josh Allen has 57 passing touchdowns. The last 2 years, Dak Prescott has 15 interceptions. Josh Allen has 19 interceptions. It's not even a debate.
Yes.
Josh Allen has been better the last 2 years.
What's that?
It's not a debate.
No.
What you're doing is you're using the aggregates and not using them at individual times when they occur. That's like saying, okay, you know what, Peyton Manning, you had 55 touchdowns 1 year. The next year you come back and you got 20. Now, who in the hell is going to beat that? You're trying to say a guy who comes out here like Dak Prescott who has a better 2019, correct?
Then Josh Allen's 2019,
yes, sir. And then in 2020, he only had a better one because Dak couldn't finish the race.
That matters.
It doesn't matter to the point where we're going to drop him so low, we're going to give him still some credit for having a historical pace after 5 games. That's why I don't think you're factoring it.
Acho giving credit for my man showing up to take the SAT. You just gave Josh Allen 400 points for putting his name on the SAT just because he showed up and finished the season. Like, come on, let's be better. Let's at least evaluate
that's
him if he
the
gets
problem.
The question, right?
When you have
come
an
on.
Insane year and then you have a subpar year, you don't give him greatness. You say above average. That's all we are trying to say.